Good morning. We are about to start the drive up to the Rogaine. All packed and ready to go. It'll be about 2.5 hour to drive up. At the moment it's about 7:30, so ideally get there before 10. And the race starts at 12, so plenty of time to mark out our map, etc.
After an uneventful drive up, we arrived at Rogaine HQ, affectionately known in Rogaining circles as the Hash House. Despite Sydney experiencing the wettest summer in 30 years, we were lucky enough to have a picture-perfect day for the event. As always, the New South Wales Rogaining Club had everything really well set up and organised, and we wasted no time in checking in, collecting our maps, and starting to debate which route we should take.
A possibility to extend or cut, and another possibility to extend or cut.
A few minutes before the start, it was time for the briefing.
You're not allowed to use Putty Road at all, except in emergency.
And then, it was showtime.
Alright, and we're off, 6 hours. Minute number one.
It wasn't long before we had our first change of plans. The first of many this race.
About 2 or 3 minutes in, we've already changed our plans. A whole bunch of people started heading off in the checkpoint that we were heading in, so we've diverted and changed over to another one. From HH, we're gonna go 36, but now we're gonna go grab number 42. See, there's all the people that are heading off in the direction that we were originally meant to head off. And then there's two people that way heading off in our new direction. Much more fun. Found the first one, a little bit more to your right. All right, first checkpoint. Nav wasn't too bad. Almost walked onto it. Pretty easy to find though.
With the first checkpoint collected, the change of plans continued.
So rather than backtracking to 36, we might as well go 42, 72, 44, and then back to our original plan, and that way we've got in 3 extra ones. Yeah. What do you think?
So, we have time.
Plan keeps changing.
I was still definitely very optimistic at this stage. You can hear Bess is a little bit hesitant because she had the much better, especially in hindsight, idea of wanting to stick to our plan.
So if we start to run out of time, we can go from 51 to 40 and then back to the hash house, so we can cut these out as a worst case scenario. So there's some options. And there's also the option of going from there to there.
Yeah.
Cool.
All right, let's go. Third checkpoint, or actually about, let me have a look here, about 50 minutes in, so taking a little bit longer than what we first thought, but it's a beautiful day. So I think according to the map, it's going to be just down there.
Thankfully this one wasn't too hard to find, but the bush bashing between checkpoints was starting to take its toll and eat up a lot more time than we thought it was going to. So it's time to reevaluate our plans and again make some more changes.
44 done, and this isn't too far away, she's just behind me, but I'll show you guys what we've done so far on the map. So we started over here at HH, which is the hash house. Instead of going for 36, we headed up to 42, then got 41, 72, 44. And now we've got the decision whether we're going to head down to 36, but it's a bit of uphill than quite steep downhill, or we'll just head onto the road, catch the road, and then back onto our original track at 21. Which, considering we are almost at an hour with 5 to go, and the other one's only worth 36, might be worth skipping, considering what all those extra ones, and head to 21 is our next bet. But we'll have a quick chat. Got us on the trail. So where are we on the map? So we're at 44.
We just kind of walked down.
Yep, and then we walked.
So we're in the flat bit here.
Yep. Coming across our first wildlife. Get ready. Cows. It's okay. We're vegans. Making up for a bit of time that we lost during the scrubby section. Nice and easy terrain, so jogging it out.
It wasn't long before the road section ended and we were straight back into the bush.
To the next checkpoint now, a little bit of bush bashing. It's not too thick, but it's pretty steep. This is about level, so we're going up. So there you go, on a bit of an angle, you can see. It's not too steep, but it's definitely the most direct path. So about another 200 meters or so to the next waypoint if our nav is actually accurate.
Spoiler alert,
we shall see.
It wasn't.
Should be in that direction again, probably about hopefully less than 50 now. I think I'm not too sure on the distance, but I'm pretty confident on the direction, so I'm gonna keep recording and see how accurate we are, because I think as soon as I pop over the slip we should see it.
I couldn't have been more wrong.
It might be to my left. Let's have a look.
Here I start to get the first feeling that something's not quite right.
So potentially I think it's somewhere here, because I'm after number 45, so you can see here it's on the edge of this cliff here, so I'm kind of towards the top, so that's why I'm thinking. We obviously didn't come up the cliff, we were just to the right of it, so I'm thinking it's got to be slightly to our left, because we erred a little bit on the right for a little bit of side of caution. Keep going. See, and this is where it continues to go up, which on the map is this part here. I don't know how well that comes out on the GoPro.
This is really where I should have stuck more to my left. Trusted the compass, trusted my instinct, and stuck to that left-hand side rather than slowly sloping my way up towards the right, trying to get the high ground, thinking I'd get a better look.
Come on, where are you? Just gonna head on over to the edge and see if I can see it, because this is the cliff line, I'm pretty sure, which I don't want to get too close to. So again, according to the map, but I want to be careful I'm not on that cliff line. That's going to be the kicker. See, now I'm starting to think it's back here.
That's pretty much where I realize where my constant creep up on the right-hand side up the hill has made me jump on to the next cliff line.
That's a pretty big gain from that one to that one, which I felt I could have just done. Or it's back there. It might be down here somewhere. Ah, there it is. Yeah, so what's to my left? To your left. Just through there. So I did miss it. Yeah, that way. There we go. So I'd miss a little bit. It was to my left. And we did go generously
to the right a little bit too much. So then when we shot the compass bearing, it was pointed out that direction, but I should have stayed to the left. So I guess that's kind of what it is. It's a little bit of using the compass, but also still some intuition and kind of judging the terrain and trying to have these kind of backstops, knowing when you've kind of gone too far, something doesn't feel quite too right. So just stop, backtrack a little bit if you need to, have a closer look at the terrain, and then it usually comes good, like it did in this instance. But you can see if you kind of didn't stop and double check and didn't trust that kind of feeling, could have just kept going and going and going. But thankfully something didn't feel right, so stopped, double checked, went backwards a little bit, tried to line the terrain up with the map, and had that kind of feeling that it was to the left, and all those together yield the results. And so now from 45 to 58.
That one took up a fair bit of extra time, so we decided to change plans again to reduce the bush bashing and get back onto the main trail a little bit sooner.
So we'll just go straight to 90 because we're running a little bit low on time. We're on 2 hours already, and 23 is not worth that much.
No, I think skip that.
Okay. We just found number 58, that one just there. And that was extremely time consuming. As you can see, there's no real features there. So I was going off these spurs, and the first one I went down this spur here because I saw the one on the right, thinking we were actually here. But then I found it steep on the left. I'm like, oh, we have to jump across to the next one. But then because the terrain was quite bushy, we overshot it and ended up there. So I just backtrack and thankfully just found it up ahead. But that was definitely a bit of a tough one. Just got over to the road, thank goodness. That was another pretty exhausting bush bash. So currently from 58 onto the road here, and then follow the road around to 90, and then we'll have a break with some food. It's almost 3 hours in, so
as you can hear, I'm getting pretty exhausted by this stage, and we're both pretty keen to get to checkpoint 90 and actually sit down and have some food, which we haven't done yet.
Done checkpoint number 90, and then we stopped to finally have some food. Probably actually left it way too long before eating, because went about the first 3 hours without really eating anything, which is a bit too long. But definitely stocked up and got into the food. Our carrots, was it cucumber, chips, M&Ms, chocolate, a lot of everything, and heaps of water. And had a good look at the map and just changed our route a little bit. We've got about 2 hours until sunset, so it really starts to get dark pretty quick, and it's already getting quite chilly. So we've simplified our route a little bit, cut a few checkpoints out since we did a little bit extra at the start, and just made it a little bit simpler that if we want to, we can kind of barrel out and head back to the hash house, the HQ, a little bit earlier if we start to fall, or if we start to fall a little bit behind. So see how we go. Still a good bit of bush bashing and a good bit of the trail left. It's we're 3.5 hours. We're just shy of 3.5 hours, so a good 2.5 left of the race. Onwards.
After we'd stopped for food, we were trying to make up a little bit of extra time, so we were rushing along the trail and actually missed one of our key turnoffs to get a few extra checkpoints.
Maybe one of our last ones. We made some more navigational errors, which forced us to skip a few. Decided to do that rather than double back because we're running a little bit low on time. And we've only got a few more options to collect more points. So it'll be this one, and depending how long that takes, or this takes, it'll be another one or two, then heading back. We'll probably get back a little bit early, but rather early than late. And let's see. So, somewhere there. Success, just found number 38. Right there, thank goodness. That was pretty easy to find, nice open ground. Not very time consuming at all, which was good. What are we at now? Let me grab my watch. 4 hours and 14 minutes. So, just under two to go. So, a few more checkpoints and heading back. Just approaching checkpoint 60, which should be just at the top here. And there it is. Nice. I think this will be our second last one. So, one more after this, and we head back to HQ. So, whoop. Hang up, that's right. So yeah, 60, head back to the trail, go along the trail to the junction, and then get to 33. And then back we go. And we've got about an hour and 15 minutes to go, so should be up. Just hunting down the last checkpoint now before we head back. Somewhere in this vicinity. If my navigation is correct, which it really hasn't been for most of the day. Think I see it. Boom. Lucky last. Okay. So we're on our way back now. I'm done? All right, cool. All right, let's head back. Nice. Done. Do you mind? Done. 6 hours.
5 and a half.
Yeah, well, it took us 5 and a half. Maybe you could have gone to one more checkpoint, but that's alright.
Not
It was good. Rogaine, done.